OpenAI has come with a banger of an update, and I really feel this is going to change how we generate images as well as edit them. Today, OpenAI's ChatGPT is going to get 4.0 image generation and editing features. And from the demos what they have showed, I really feel this is going to be the world's best AI image editor. So first, let me show you what they have done in the demo video, and later I will also explain you through their page that they are having. So this is the first text to image prompt that they gave to ChatGPT. So here it says, a tall POV image of me in an old loft, film crew present facing me, and there is a sheet of paper on the table. There is text written on the paper. So here it has said, focus on the paper, background out of focus. Paper occupies most of the page, and this is going to be the text on that particular paper. So this is quite a complicated prompt, because there is one condition, second condition, and sub conditions, and this is the text over there. And you'd be mind blown how well this image got generated. So this is the image that got generated. Here there is a sheet of paper on the table, and the focus is on the paper. Background is out of focus. You just see here, there is a crew out of focus, and the paper is on the table, and the paper is on focus. Next, the text over here, part 1, part 2. And as you can see, we are having part 1, part 2. And just look at this text. Everything looks super, super amazing. And I really feel they have scaled up their image generation. And let's go with the next one. And here they are having an image where they take selfie. And next, they ask this to turn into an anime frame. This is quite common. And next, they're asking this to convert into a meme titled Feel the AGI, and ChatGPT has basically added the text Feel the AGI to it. So you can also add text to any of your existing images. So it can basically create any posters with text, or in case if you're having any posters which you want to like add a particular text or replace a particular text, upload it to ChatGPT and it can literally edit your images. And this is basically a comic image related to Albert Einstein in Japanese style, and this has also done an amazing job. And the next one is what blows my mind off. Basically, here they are uploading 4 images, and one image has like an instrument thing, second one has some animal, third one has this Albert Einstein image, the third one, and fourth one is an image of a dog. And the prompt that they're giving is, create a memorial coin based on these 4 objects. So that particular coin should have context from these 4 images, and they're also giving the color code and with the text 4.0 image gen with today's date. And you'll be mind blown what it has done. It has created this amazing coin. So for Albert Einstein, we are having this face and a formula and that instrument thing and that animal thing. It literally all the stuff that are present in these 4 images. It has literally converted everything into this amazing coin with 4.0 image gen and the date exactly similar to how we see in real life coins. And then they go and ask to make it transparent, and it was also able to remove the background of this image. So these are very small demos, and let me now take you to their official blog of OpenAI. They would have given some amazing examples. For example, this one is an whiteboard session, and this is the prompt: a wide image taken with the phone of a glass whiteboard in a room overlooking the Bay of Bridge. And if you scroll down here, there is a whiteboard and we are having this text over here. So these are the text that are needs to be appear on the image: pros, cons, fixes, everything, literally everything is there. And the great thing is overlooking the Bay Bridge, which is in San Francisco. And here in the background, like a shadow, a glaring shadow, I can see the San Francisco Bridge. And that person is also visible. So they have literally got everything on to that image. And next prompt is going to be selfie view of the photographer as she turns around to give him high five. We have also got that particular person giving high five. And just look at the realism of this image. And apart from that, they are having this meaningful words example. And just look at the quality of image. So I guess they have done an amazing job in incorporating text onto an image. We have this comic strip. Again, good science experiment. And yeah, so they have given us this prompt, an infographic explaining Newton's prism experimental in great detail. So this is crazy level of, you know, detail. And here also they're having generate a POV of a person drawing this, and that particular poster has been generated in a POV image, and they have literally got Isaac Newton showing this in an table. So these are some of the examples what you can generate from 4O image generation, normal image, and then you can improvise from that image with hyper accuracy. Next is going to be text onto an image, and next is generating comical content somewhat like this. Here they're having so many dialogues which has beautifully embedded into an image, and next one is going to be creating posters or some kind of infographic thing. So imagine you are doing PowerPoint presentation, you just need to write a prompt over here and directly cut this image and put it in your PowerPoint. That's it, you are ready to go. And here they have given us some examples for text rendering. So as you can see here, this is an image generated and not even there is a single mismatch of that particular text. So I guess this is going to be the world's best text on the image model. We had many models doing this before, but I have never seen this much of text with hyper accuracy. Next is going to be the menu card. So just look at this, right? They have actually given an entire, you know, prompt saying what are the stuff they want to have in their menu card, like the prices as well as the contents, ingredients in it. And just look at this, it has beautifully designed an entire menu card. So that's super stunning, and I don't see even a single mismatch of that text. So that's how good this particular model is. And next is an invitation, and I don't know how many people are going to lose their jobs just because of this particular feature. And just look at this, like literally it has created an invitation. So in case if you're having an event, any function, you can just literally go and ask ChatGPT to create one rather than paying a graphic designer or something. So that's super good. And next one is the multi-turn generation. This is basically editing your own image. For example, in case if you want to edit a particular image or add some extra features into that image. For example, here they have given an input photo of a cat and they are asking to add a detective hat to it. And just look at this, it has literally kept the real object in that image untouched and has added a lens as well as a Sherlock Holmes cap. That's how good it is. And next prompt is turning this into an game. And this is the image that we are getting. That looks super, super stunning. Another one, another point of view of the cat image. So that's it. You can literally generate UX, UI also. Like in case if you're developing a game, this can literally give you tons of ideas how it should be. And here they're having a poem like structure. Yeah, you can just go through it. More examples I see, the more I am like amazed to see how good it is in generating text onto the images, because I've never seen any model do this well. Because usually even if there are like two sentences, that model will be so hard to get text over the image. And next one is the instruction following. Yeah, this is a great thing. We need to really read this. While other systems struggle with 5 to 8 objects, GPT-4o can handle up to 20 to 20 different objects on a single image. That's absolutely insane. As you can see here, they have given here a 16 sentence prompt, and I guess it has been able to generate everything spot on. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 by 4, it's 16. So it has literally got 16 sentences onto a single image. So that's just mind blowing. And next one is the MTCD. This is just a common one, normal one compared to other things GPT-4o has been able to do. And next one is in context learning. GPT-4o can analyze and learn from user uploaded images. So this is basically like you uploading like 4 to 5 images to ChatGPT and asking it to create a next image from those 4 or 5 images. So basically it needs to understand what you have given in those existing images, then understand your prompt and then generate the image. For example, here they have uploaded some prototypes of ancient cycle. So this is how cycle used to look, and they have asked to generate a cycle with triangular wheels, and it has amazingly done it, like the triangular wheel over here, but in the prompt they have given with circular wheels. So it has understood the pattern in this uploaded images, then it has got hold of the prompt, then it has generated the amazing images. And now they have asked this to put this image in New York City, and it has also done that. Just look at the accuracy of this. Like, it has literally got this random 1900s poster style image into New York City, and I could see a cab behind it. So that's how good this particular thing is going to be. And a photorealistic image of a blue chainsaw, and they have got this particular image. So in case, imagine you are uploading this particular image, and next they say make an ad for this chainsaw of a grandma carving turkey at Thanksgiving dinner. So a grandma is using this particular chainsaw and cutting the turkey. So that's stunning. So in case if you're having any product and you want to make like a commercial poster or anything, ChatGPT is the spot. And other examples, you can just turn any random cartoon into hyper realistic images like this. So they are also having this best of 8. So in case if you don't, you know, get the right one, you have to like rebuild the prompt again. And from architectural design, it has converted it into an amazing image. Best of 4 for this one. And next one is going to be world knowledge. So this is basically if you ask any prompt about general things. For example, here we are having cocktail recipes, and you just give the prompt, make me a professionally shot photorealistic diagram of a top selling cocktails in my bar with recipes labeled on each drink. So here you have just specified this one. You haven't given how each and every cocktail should look, what are the texts that is going to be on that. You're just having a generic prompt. So basically GPT-4o has to get knowledge from its own and then generate this image. And as you can see, we haven't specified the ingredients. It has to communicate with the text model, get what are the famous cocktail drinks and their ingredients at first, and then it has to generate this image. So for this, a text model should also work and an image model should also work, and both of them needs to go hand in hand. That's such an amazing image for like combination of both text and image model over there. So we're also having like other examples, like I showed you one earlier like this. Yeah, this is like a different types of whale. So educational poster on different types of whales. So it can also generate amazing images even if you don't give like any context in the prompt. And next one is going to be photorealism, and some of the images that they generated were super hyper realistic. Just look at this image over here, this one, this image also. No one could literally say this is like a fake image or something. This one, this image, yeah. And finally, limitation. So they have said their model isn't perfect and they are working, and they will also get those improvements as it goes. So cropping, sometimes you will get the cropped output. So as you can see here, the cropped, and hallucinations and editing precision. And so they have like quite a few like limitations over here, but they're just like improving on it. So yeah, and they have all the safety as usual, and access and availability. And this particular feature is going to get rolled out by today for all the paid as well as the free users. So you can just try using it on your own. And yeah, they have done an amazing job over here, and this will also be like coming to the API for the developers out there. So that's pretty much it. I think this particular feature is going to have an extreme impact, and as I told you from what they have shown in the demo and these images over here, I really feel this is going to have a better editing capability than Grok and Gemini 2.2. yeah, so that's the video, guys. Do let me know in the comments what you think about it. I hope you'd have found it useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.